Good afternoon. Welcome to the court's annual Constitution Day celebration. I'm Judge Carolyn McHugh of the Utah Court of Appeals, and I'm your master of ceremonies today because I chair the court's judicial outreach committee, which hosts this event every year. In 2005, President Bush signed a bill designating September 17th as Constitution Day. September 17th was selected because it was the day that 39 of the 55 founding fathers signed our Constitution. We are celebrating this momentous occasion this year on September 19th because we didn't think that you'd all come to the Matheson Courthouse on Saturday to celebrate. For nearly 225 years, the Constitution has served as the cornerstone of our nation's democracy and principal guarantor of freedom and equality for all Americans. Through the Constitution, our founding fathers created a system that both separated and blended powers vertically between the states and the federal government and horizontally among the three branches of government: the legislative, executive, and judicial. Each branch serves as a check and balance on the powers of the other. Today's program will begin with the presentation of colors by the East High School Color Guard. Following the presentation of the colors, we will recite the Pledge of Allegiance, after which Frank Chavez will sing the national anthem. This will be followed by a reading of the preamble and Article 3, the article that deals with the judiciary of the U.S. Constitution. Those sections of the U.S. Constitution will be read by the judges that are sitting next to me, our Chief Justice Christine M. Durham of the Utah Supreme Court, my colleague on the Court of Appeals, Stephen Roth, the presiding judge of the 3rd District Court, Royal Hansen, and Jim Michie of the 3rd District Juvenile Court. I now invite the color guard to post the colors. We'll now have the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. We'll now have the national anthem. Thank you. Thank you to the East High Color Guard and to Frank Chavez for that inspiring rendition of the national anthem. Before we begin the reading of Article 3 of the United States Constitution, I'd like you all to come forward instead of standing back so that you can hear better and join us. And I'll now turn it over to the Chief Justice.
The preamble to the Constitution of the United States of America. We, the people of the United States, in order to form a more perfect union, establish justice, ensure domestic tranquility, provide for the common defense, promote the general welfare, and secure the blessings of liberty to ourselves and our posterity, do ordain and establish this Constitution for the United States of America.
Article 3, Section 1. The judicial power of the United States shall be vested in one Supreme Court and in such inferior courts as the Congress may from time to time ordain and establish. The judges, both of the Supreme and inferior courts, shall hold their offices during good behavior and shall at stated times receive for their services a compensation which shall not be diminished during their continuance in office.
Section 2. The judicial power shall extend to all cases in law and equity arising under this Constitution, the laws of the United States and treaties made or which shall be made under their authority, to all cases affecting ambassadors, other public ministers and consuls, to all cases of admiralty and maritime jurisdiction, to controversies to which the United States shall be a party, to controversies between two or more states, between a state and citizens of another state, between citizens of different states, between citizens of the same state claiming lands under grants of different states, and between a state or the citizens thereof and foreign states, citizens, or subjects. In all cases affecting ambassadors or other public ministers or consuls, and those in which a state shall be a party, the Supreme Court shall have original jurisdiction. In all other cases before mentioned, the Supreme Court shall have appellate jurisdiction, both as to law and fact, with such exceptions and under such regulations as the Congress shall make. The trial of all crimes, except in the case of impeachment, shall be by jury, and such trials shall be held in the state where the said crimes shall have been committed. But when not committed within any state, the trial shall be at such place or places as the Congress may by law have directed.
Section 3, treason against the United States shall consist only in levying war against them, or in adhering to their enemies, giving them aid and comfort. No person shall be convicted of treason unless on the testimony of two witnesses to the same overt act, or on confession in open court. The Congress shall have power to declare the punishment of treason, but no attainder of treason shall work corruption of blood or forfeiture except during the life of the person attainted.
I'd like to thank my colleagues for reading that important language from the Constitution. As Americans, we cherish our national heritage, but sometimes we forget that we have an obligation to understand our system of government and to work to make sure that others understand it as well, because in knowledge is preservation. I want to leave you with two quotes today. The first is from James Madison. It states, The happy union of these states is a wonder, their constitution a miracle, their example the hope of liberty throughout the world. And then a quote from Andrew Jackson is my second quote, and it states, "All the rights secured to the citizens under the Constitution are worth nothing and a mere bubble, except guaranteed to them by an independent and virtuous judiciary." Thank you very much. I hope you enjoyed our celebration of the Constitution today.